If the napkins don't fit into this bin, then I have to get rid of some.
Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Today I'm in my entryway and I'm gonna give you a tour of my dining room. I wanna make changes to it, but there are major decisions that I need to make, or maybe not so major for some of you, but for me it is, and I've been stuck for about a couple years. So come along with me, help me make those decisions, and I hope it all works out. From my living room, it is the dining room. So a lot of places here in Phoenix, in Arizona, it's very typical to have the living dining room just kind of be one big space, right? Or lead into the other. And what I do like about this house is that it has this arch, even though I don't like that. I wish it was just a round arch that kind of separates the space, which is nice. And we always have a stand fan. And this is the table that I finally decided to get after like literally 3 years of looking online. And I love it. It's the right color. It's the right vibe. And I got these chairs from Amazon. I wanted velvet chairs and I absolutely love them. They're pretty comfortable. I think they're 2 hour chairs. You can sit here for 2 hours and not be bothered. Longer than that, you know, kind of your tush starts hurting. Okay, then I do have another plant here. Love it. It's doing well. I got that pot to match the ones in the living room. And I got this map. This was like my favorite map of all, my favorite wall decor of all time for like years. I saw it in Restoration Hardware and I found this dupe on Etsy. Well, that store is no longer open on Etsy, but it was only $100. And you know the ones at Restoration Hardware are so expensive. I assume they still do this, but Restoration Hardware isn't my style anymore. And it was so hard to get this on the wall. And honestly, this is up by duct tape, but nobody would know that. And I kept it there and I thought, you know what? I'm just gonna put a frame around it. I'm gonna get it framed. I mean, I went back and forth. So anyway, it's been up there for a few years and my husband is pretty much over it. And I'm okay, you know, like I'm willing to change it. I asked a few friends, they're like, yeah, I think you should change it. So I've been looking and like the same thing with my living room. I can't decide, so I'm just gonna leave it up there for now, not let it bother me. And by the way, I have these, I have to link these because these are amazing. You know, people always need plugs and outlets, and then it's also a night light, so when it's dark, the night light turns on. Okay, and then this is a view of our backyard. And then I'm walking over here just to show you this space. So this is the main part where I have to make the major decisions. By the way, that says our last name and it's like a painting. Someone is a street painter, a street artist, did it in San Francisco by the pier when we were still newlywed. So I love that, can keep that. I might change the color of the matting, but for now, that's what it is. So we definitely want the beverage cooler because as you saw in my previous video, this is what we use for entertaining. Like I don't get a cooler, I don't get, you know, lay out the drinks. All our drinks are there and we have the ice machine in our kitchen, okay? And that's the snack basket, that's my wine fridge. So I don't know if I should have something custom on this wall or the wall behind me because I do bring out chafing dishes, or let's say you just have a buffet and you're having a larger party, then I just want a place to put it on and not use these tables or bring out tables, you know, those folding tables. So I don't know. I'm just trying to figure it out. I mean, I have like a vision, what do you call it? A design board and my notes, either custom go all the way up and then have the wine glasses, you know, cause I have that right now. Let me show you. So I do have, see, I do have wine glasses up there. Okay. And then my espresso is here. Sorry guys, here, my Nespresso is here. So functionally, it all works, you know, but those just extra wine from different parties we had. But aesthetically, obviously it's not what I want. I got this for like $50 at a garage sale, I think literally like 15 years ago. And it takes me a long time to make decisions as far as the design in my house, or, you know, because I'm not that good at it. Okay. Let's see, I have the fortune cookies from the entryway table that I need to put in here. Let's do that. Okay, I brought them all over here. And let's see, oopsie, sorry. Bring these to the front. Four of them fit there. So the rest, I think I'm just gonna put them. I wish I could fit them in the back. Oh, maybe here. Just kind of put them on the side there. All right, I was able to fit one more there and just have it like that. So now it's front and center. People can take them. All right, and so for now, I just have this light and coasters there, and this one does have drawers, so let's take a look. Okay, I know this looks junky, but it is stuff I want. It's just not put in nicely. So I have these wine bottle openers here that I put in the guest room. Oh, here's the other bowls. Those go in the buffet table in the entryway. And here's just some more bowls there, see? Yeah, these don't go here. Okay. And I think this is just gift wrap I got from Cost Plus World Market years ago. And I think it's pretty. And this is just butane for when you use this for like creme brulee or something. Okay, so that we just had to tidy up. All right, this bottom drawer is where I put the placemats. I got rid of a lot of placemats and just kept these. So these are some more nambe. It's like a platter. Yeah, it's like a platter, love it. Wonder if I should just, no, I'll just keep that here. And then this is a bottle opener. Still nambe. They fit nicely in here, but I wonder if I should put them with all the other nambe. And then some more cheese servers. Okay, so all my napkin rings are here. And if they don't fit, then I have to get rid of them. This, I have three sets of napkins. If the napkins don't fit into this bin, then I have to get rid of some. So I used to have like probably 10 sets of napkins, and finally got them down to these. One is like this one's like an Easter. Then fall-ish, and then this peacock color. So I might use these for, I will use these for Thanksgiving, but I think there's only like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there's only 8 of them. Yeah, I'll still use them. Because I have 9, and then for Friendsgiving, I have 10. I mean, yeah, I have 10. Okay, so they fit, so I'm keeping them. All right, so I'm trying to do this. This is an old armoire, so even the drawers fall out, so I have to kind of hold it like that. So that's that. Let's put this nambe. I'm going to think about this nambe. I might put it there in the entryway table. Another one can go here. Just fits nicely like that. And then placemats. I'll just put them in here. These are the placemats that we always use. Okay. Right, for the table, I like to just keep it open like that, and I only have 2 coasters here. These are marble, I think, but 2 of them have broken. I do want to get at least 2 more, if not 6 for the whole table, but that's not really that important. And then I got this, gosh, I think TJ Maxx, and I like to put fresh lemons in there as much as possible. Obviously, there's none right now, or the fruit of the season, and I like that better than any other type of decor is just having fresh fruit. Okay, friends, so that's an overview of my dining room. Just want to give you what it looks, show you what it looks like right now. If I make any changes, I'll make sure to do a video. And if you want more organizing videos, click the next one and I'll see you next time. Bye.